I'm going to show you how to make a sort of boosted terrain effect, total hack, using thematic data in ArcGIS Online. This video is brought to you by Dr. Mark Francek. More on that at the end. Let's start with the very best data, and that can be found from Living Atlas. I'm going to look for life expectancy. I'll add county health rankings from 2021. Really great data source, by the way. And it's got it aggregated to the nation and the state, but I only need county, so I'll ungroup it and delete those other things. And you can see it's got a lot of interesting data, but we're after life expectancy. And believe it or not, I don't want it to be thematically colored. I'm just gonna make it all one color, and I'm gonna play with filters. I'm gonna make a bunch of layers, each filtered to a specific age range. In this case, I've filtered it to only show areas where the life expectancy is 85 and over. Now I'll duplicate this layer, drag it to the bottom, rename it 80 to 85, and then set the filter to be 80 to 85. So I've got these mutually exclusive sets of layers, all showing me different ranges of life expectancy. And I'll just keep doing this all the way down until I hit all of the life expectancies, 5 years at a time. And those gaps are areas of no data. Next, I'm going to open the style for these and change their colors from that default fleshy rust color to shades of gray. And the oldest life expectancy will be the lightest, brightest, in which case it's almost white, and then it'll get progressively darker as I step down in these little layers of life expectancy ranges. The shorter the life expectancy, the darker it is in this case. And we're pretty much making a grayscale map of life expectancy with five classes, but I've separated them into five different layers. That's all. Okay, next, I'm going to dig into the beautiful, beautiful effects available in ArcGIS Online. So with each of them selected, I'll go into the Effects tab, I'll activate Drop Shadow, and I'll give it a 4-pixel shadow, and I'll turn off Automatically Adjust based on scale, so it's consistent at all the scales. And we get this kind of weird 3D looking grayscale map where each age break is darker and shaded, and they kind of stack up on top of each other precisely because we separated them into individual layers and gave each layer its own drop shadow effect. And now I'm going to create a new group layer and put them all inside that group in the same order because I want to use a blend mode, and I don't want to use the blend mode on the individual layers. I want to use the blend mode on the group layer. So with this group layer selected, I'll go into the appearance area and I'll choose the blend mode of overlay. Overlay uses the lights and the darks to see through to the underlying imagery and make it brighter or darker. Lastly, I'm going to add a little bit of context. So I'll go back into Living Atlas and I'm going to search for something called Human Geography, my favorite vector base map layer for borders and labels and stuff. It's great. So I'm going to move these to the base map area because I added them as a label. So I move them to the base map, I'll open up the base map, and I'm going to drag them into the reference layer so they render on top of all my data. And I'll give the borders a multiply blend mode so they darken everything and you can still see through it. And then I'll just make the layer labels a little semi-transparent. And the result is a pseudo terrain driven by data. Life expectancy is the peaks and low life expectancy is the troughs. I've added some labels in here so when you zoom in you can see what the actual data says for context. It's a lot of fun. I hope you give it a shot. You can turn your figurative thematic data's peaks and valleys into literal peaks and valleys. This video was brought to you by Dr. Mark Francek of Central Michigan University. Dr. Francek was one of my geography professors, and he brought an energy and enthusiasm for teaching that I have completely tried to rip off since then. Thank you, Dr. Francek.